If the military need for bigger and bigger bombers was overrun by the increasing sophistication of the defences and the missions, there was one area of military need that continued to require the maximum possible lift. When the Second World War began, there simply were no transport aeroplanes in the modern sense. As a result, during the war, the Germans and the Allies both meddled with the risky and expensive business of employing gliders. The German Messerschmitt company's Gigant serves as the best example. The thing was designed in expectation of being used in the invasion of England and was rushed through design and into production. It actually represents a pretty good effort at a probably impossible task, and some of its features, like the clamshell doors in the nose, have become commonplace. But it was very big and designed to take off weighing around 40 tons, loaded with tanks. Quite simply, the thing that had been overlooked was the finding of a suitable tug. Leaving the engines off the Gigant made them much simpler to mass produce in a hurry, but they still had to be dragged into the air, and there was no plane available that had the spare power to accomplish that, even with rocket assistance from pods on the Gigant's wings. Three twin-engined Messerschmitt 110s strained to haul the thing along in an operation that was truly and awesomely dangerous. There were a great number of ways for this process to foul up, and it fouled up repeatedly, sometimes with massive loss of life. Messerschmitt eventually did the logical thing and added six engines to their monster. But although as transports these ME-323s did perform effectively, in a war theatre they were too slow to survive and were easy meat for any Allied fighter they happened to blunder into. Unable to run and virtually defenceless, despite the slots for the passengers to fire off their rifles through.